Okay, good day. So today we will be going to discuss about ice refrigeration. And vapor absorption rep system, refrigeration system. So we'll start with ice refrigeration. So when you are trying to use refrigeration, so mainly in order to preserve the goods or the product or prolong its life, we freeze it, no, below its freezing temperature to slow down the growth of bacteria and other microorganisms that decomposes the substance, no, either the meat or the ice, no, also undergoes this. So in order to measure the amount of heat needed, the amount of load, no, in or amount of load needed generic for ice. So for example, fish, or it depends upon the type of substance or goods that you are going to freeze. So the main formula is Q ice, for example, water. We have mass of water, Cp of water. For example, we freeze ice water, no? Temperature of water minus T at 0 degrees Celsius, meaning this is the freezing temperature. Freezing temp. So, then plus mass of water again times the latent heat of fusion. So, the latent heat of fusion is converts change of phase, no? Change of phase from liquid to solid. Okay, so plus mass of water again. So this is latent heat of fusion, meaning the amount of heat needed to freeze, no? to remove in order to transform liquid to solid. Latent heat of fusion. So plus M mass of water, Cp of ice, so times the temperature freezing, which is 0 degrees Celsius at, for example, water, because we want ice, minus the temperature, which is final, or the temperature that we want it to be freeze, no? Below freezing. So basically, to write this up, Qi equals to, you could also common factor, no? Mass of water times Cp of water times, sometimes for generic purposes, this is the T1, meaning the initial temperature in which the body is at ambient temperature, meaning at normal temperature, at normal environment, minus the temperature freezing. So, may kung dili siya, like for example, meat or fish, Q of fish, ano siya, mass of fish. For example, kanilang. So we have T1, initial temperature, to temperature freezing. So kay different substances, different goods, lain masyag freezing temperature. So for water lang, it is at 0 degrees Celsius. Plus the latent heat of fusion, LF, of the substance. This is for water. Then plus the Cp of it when it is freeze, no? For example, if this is ice, this is the Cp of ice. And the Cp of ice is simply, Cp of ice or Cpi is simply equal to Cp of water divided by 2. So that is the Cp of ice times temperature freezing minus temperature final, T2. Okay? So like that, we just common factor the mass of water, no? So we have a sample problem in order for you to appreciate this equation, no, of solving the amount of load, no, the amount of refrigerating effect needed to freeze a substance, no, at a certain mass. Sample 1. 1 metric ton of fish is to be freeze, no? So the substance or the good we are going to freeze is a fish, no? Or fishes, no? So because it amounts to 1 metric ton, so 1000 kilogram, no? That is a lot. Used to be freeze or refrigerated. Is to be refrigerated from a temperature of 30 degrees Celsius. So this is its initial temperature, the temperature at ambient, no, at normal environment, to the final freezing temperature of negative 5 degrees Celsius in 10 hours. So we are specific with the time, meaning we could have mass flow, no? Because we have mass divided by time, it will be mass per unit time, no? So that is a mass flow. The freezing temperature, so we're given with the freezing temperature is negative 1 degree Celsius. Now for fish, the freezing temperature is negative 1 degree Celsius. For ice, it is 0 degree Celsius. But here, it is fish. The specific heat below and above freezing are 0.4 kilojoules per kilogram degree Celsius and 0.8 kilojoules per kilogram degree Celsius. Remember, this is below, so this is below and this is above, because this is respectively. Okay, so this is for below freezing, meaning this is the CP of ice, no, for when it is freeze below freezing. This is above freezing. So na. And the latent heat is of fusion siya, because this is freezing. So if this is freezing, this latent heat that is talked here is about fusion. Okay. Is 435 kilojoules per kilogram. Allow, so natin allowance, 20% additional heat load. So the amount of Q that we will, that what the amount of Q that we will be going to solve here will be added with an allowance of 20% or a factor of 1.2 as additional heat load to compensate for heat losses, unintended heat losses, no? So determine the refrigerating load. So once the heat load is the actual Q, so that is the heat load. Pero kung ada na nimo og allow 20% additional, muna na imong refrigerating load, muna na gamito nimo sa imong refrigerating effect design. Kining heat load muna siya yung actual na heat substance. Putangan pa man imong allowance. So the refrigerating load in tons of refrigeration. Okay. So we are asked with the refrigerating load in tons of refrigeration. So let us write down the givens. So we have the temperature 1, which is the temperature of the body at ambient, is 30 degrees Celsius. And we have that the temperature freezing is negative 1 degree Celsius. And we have the final temperature of negative 5 degrees Celsius below freezing. So at a time of 10 hours. Okay, so we have 1 metric ton of fish, which is equivalent to 1,000 kilogram metric ton man. Equals 1 metric kalimutan. Okay? So then we have CP above freezing of 0.8 kilojoules per kilogram degree Celsius. We have CP below of 0.4 kilojoules per kilogram degree Celsius. So CP above and CP below. So we have an allowance of the heat load that we will be going to calculate of 20%. Okay? So our required is the total refrigeration in tons of refrigeration. So, can we simply substitute that to the formula? So, when we write down the formula, it is this. So, this is heat load. Na muna yung heat load. So, Q is equals to, again, we have the mass. Then, common factor na lang nato. CP above freezing times T1 minus temperature freezing, no? So, then plus LF because it gikan sa initial temperatures ambient ni freeze to freezing temperature. Then mo transform mo phase from liquid to solid plus the final freezing temperature which is the CP below, CPB. Which is the temperature freezing minus the temperature 2. So, muna siya. So, muna siya itong heat load. So, again, when we calculate this, we are given with the mass of the fish, which is 1,000 kilogram in 10 hours. So, 10 hours times, again, because we want this to be in tons of refrigeration, and what we have is kilowatt, no? 3.516 kilowatt. Per one ton of refrigeration. So we need this to be in seconds, no? Ay, ang unit ani kay kilojoules per kilogram. So para makilowatt, we need this to be in seconds. So 3,600 seconds, 1 hour. So this cancels out the 1 hour. So the CP of a freezing is 0.8 times 30 minus negative 1 is plus 1, no? Plus 435 plus 0.4, which is the CP below freezing, times negative 1 minus negative 5. So, ma plus na siya. So, now, this is in kilojoules per kilogram. So, cancel ang kilogram. So, that will give you kilowatts. So the heat load is equal to 12.817 kilowatt. That is the heat load. Now, for the actual refrigerating load that we will have, Qrep is equal to the heat load times 1 plus 0.2 because we have an allowance of 20%. So now, we just substitute the heat load of 12.817 kilowatts times 1.2 will give you, okay? Then we will, again, okay, definition mo, okay, convert po mo na to. 3.516 kilowatts, 1 ton of refrigeration, cancel the kilowatts. So the Qrep, the refrigerating load is 4.4 tons of refrigeration, approximately 4.4 tons of refrigeration. So that is how to calculate for the load in freezing a certain food or goods, no, or ice or water, freeze ninyo. So we have another example to on ice refrigeration. So we are given with a mass of 5,000 kilogram of fish. So this 5,000 kilogram of fish is at initial temperature T1 of 6 degrees Celsius. Now we would like to freeze it at the final temperature of negative 14 degrees Celsius. And the temperature freezing of this fish is assumed to be negative 2.2 degrees Celsius. The time of freezing is 1 day or 24 hours. 24 hours. 24 hours. Okay, so we have the CP above freezing. CP above freezing of 0.7 kilocalories per kilogram degree Celsius. No, so CP below freezing, we have 0.3 kilocalories per kilogram degree Celsius. We also have the latent heat of fusion, which is 55.5 kilocalories per kilogram degree Celsius. So, but we need this to be in, we are asked to find the QREP required. So we asked to find the QREP at 30% allowance. Okay, so in tons of refrigeration, but the CPs that are given is in kilocalorie. So we will convert this in kilojoules. So in every 1 kilocalorie, there is kilo small letter CL. Okay, because capital C is already kilo na siya. So 1 kilocalorie is 4.187 kilojoules. So it times na niya to 4.187. So that will make it kilojoules. 1 kilocalorie. Kilo small letter na siya. Times 4.187. 1 kilocalorie. So we cancel the calorie. So karon mahimo na siyang kilojoules per kilogram degree Celsius, no? So we are required to find the QREP. Dili ang heat load ha, but the QREP with 30% allowance in tons of refrigeration. So we find the heat load, no? So the heat load is again mass of the fish over time times, again, CP above freezing is 0.7 times 4.187, okay? Times 6, which is the initial temperature, minus negative 2 is plus 2.2, plus latent heat, which is 55.5 times 4.187, that is the latent heat of fusion, plus CP below freezing, which is 0.3 times 4.187, okay, so the freezing temperature is negative 2.2 minus negative 14, so that is plus. Okay, so kana siya. So the when we substitute the M is 5,000 kilograms, no? So the time is 24 hours. So 24 times 3,600, that make it in seconds, no? Kana siya. So the heat load is then therefore equal to 15.7. Okay, wapa, heat load to man. 15.7 kilowatts, no? So the QREP, is 15.7 times 1.3. So this will result again to kilowatt times 3.516 kilowatts, 1 ton of refrigeration. So we calculator. Okay, so we have 15.7 times what times 1.3 divided by 3.516. So that will give us QREP of 5.8 tons of refrigeration. Okay, so that is an example for ice refrigeration. Now we will proceed to the vapor absorption refrigeration system. So when we say vapor absorption refrigeration system, it has a basic representative schematic diagram of like this. So we have the condenser. And again, we have the expansion valve. Then we have the evaporator. Then, instead of using the compressor that uses work to move the refrigerant from condenser to evaporator and cycle, no? So we will use what is called as the vapor method. Vapor absorption refrigeration method, which uses heat instead of work, no? So this is a power cycle. So this uses heat instead of the work from the compressor to move the refrigerant from one point to another, no? To cycle the refrigerant. So that is our QR. This is our QREP. So this is our, so this is a refrigeration system, REP. This is a power cycle. Okay, so because it uses an input heat to move something, no? Okay, so the COP maximum of a vapor absorption refrigeration, because this is a REP and this is a power cycle, so the COP maximum meaning basing on the Carnot principle, no? So this, if this is a Carnot refrigeration, that is TL over TH minus TL times the power. So this is the REP times the power, which is a thermal efficiency. It uses heat instead of direct work, compressor work, to move the refrigerant, no, to cycle the MR nemo. So TH minus TL over TH. This is for the power. So the result of this will be the maximum COP of the system. Of the system, meaning your bar system should not exceed the COP of bar is less than COP maximum, no? Because this is based on the Carnot principle. So we will draw first the very basic schematic of the first type of vapor absorption refrigeration, which is the water lithium bromide. So this is the water lithium bromide system. The very first vapor absorption refrigeration system. Okay, so water lithium bromide. So this is the very basic schematic diagram of a water lithium bromide vapor absorption refrigeration system. So this is our condenser. Evaporator. Evaporator. Okay, of course the direction is this arrow. So again, the first in the lithium bromide system uses what is called as a generator. Okay, so the generator is where you will apply heat. Okay, so this is the generator. Definition, generator. So the generator, so there is also another system here. So this is your vapor absorption system. This dashed with red box. This is heat. Therefore, there is Qn. Heat. Qgen, of course, going inside, no? The system, because there is heat. Then there is what is called as an absorber. Okay, so this connects here another expansion valve. Then we connect here a pump. Okay, so the vapor absorption refrigeration system uses water as the refrigerant. Water is the refrigerant. Meaning, your temperature at evaporator nga suggested ani greater than degrees Celsius. So kung magamit mo ulit yung bromide system, the evaporator temperature is it or should be above 0 degrees. Okay, so there's technical issues. So the evaporator temperature should be above 0 degrees Celsius, wherein water is the refrigerant and lithium bromide is the absorbent. Lithium bromide is the absorbent. Okay, so when we are talking, so that lithium bromide, arira na siya mo cycle ang lithium bromide. So, the water cycles here as the refrigerant. Okay, so that is a mass flow of refrigerant. So, what happens is, we will first assign points. No, so this is point one, this is point two, this is point three, this is point four. Okay, so this is point five. This is 0.6, this is 0.7, this is 0.8. So the masses that flow here is MA, here is MB, where MA is equals to MB plus MR. Okay, so this is the mass balance. So ang lithium bromide, arira na din magtuyok, ang water, arira na siya din magtuyok. With approximately the very basic is 8 points. So to explain the what happens, Q abs, this is Q rep, this is Q condenser. So here the water is boiled with the lithium bromide solution. So remember that they have different boiling points. So the water mo init ra tong lithium bromide. Ang water mo evaporate. So, yung nag-evaporate sa water, it is at saturated vapor state. Therefore, 0.1 is saturated vapor state as a result of boiling the solution. So, murag for example, nag-mix ka o nag-boil ka si water, muna nag-evaporate ang water, no? Mabilin ang residue. So, muna yung hitabo. So, the water leaves as the refrigerant. Therefore, when you are boiling this, what enters here is pure water, no? Walay lithium bromide. So again, the water, it will exit at 0.2 at saturated liquid because there is condenser, no? Liquid. So it passes the thermostatic expansion valve. So when you see this, so you could actually divide the system into high side, meaning this is the high pressure side, and this is the low side, meaning this is the low pressure side. Their pressures are dependent on the PSAT of the TSAT of the cond, no? PSAT of temperature condenser for the high side, and here is the PSAT of the temperature evaporator. So that will become your pressure in the high side and pressure in the low side. So here, because there is expansion valve, there is a conversion from liquid to vapor. So this is a wet state, no? Meaning this is a combination of both liquid and vapor at 0.3. But there is Q-rep. So therefore, Q-rep adds heat to the refrigerant, which is water, which boils it to saturated vapor at 0.4. Saturated vapor. 0.4 is... saturated vapor again. So, here, going back to the generator, so, na-evaporate naman ang katong water, so, nahimo siyang highly concentrated. Sige lang, makita ninyo ang concentration ron sa chart. So, and then, such time, the lithium bromide solution will undergo expansion valve to reduce pressure. So, highly concentrated ni dire from 7 to 8. From 7 to 8. So, inig-abot dire, niya saturated vapor ang gikan sa evaporator, mag-mix. Mag-mix sila. Mag-mix. Mag-mix sa absorber. So, meaning, pag-exit sa 0.5, so, kining spiso kayo, niya saturated vapor, mubugnaw mo to siya. Nigbugnaw to, ang kaning 5 is a saturated liquid state. Okay. So, then sa 0.6 natay pump, meaning raises the pressure from low side to high side at 0.6. So, mo pabukala na sa dire balik sa generator. So, ang lithium bromide again is dire ra magtuyok-tuyok sa vapor absorption power nato system kani. Nya ang water mo mo cycle as the refrigerant. Okay, so timan ina ninyo. Okay. So we have sample problem so that you could appreciate water lithium bromide vapor absorption refrigeration system. So I will draw again the schematic diagram. So this is the evaporator. Evaporator. So the evaporator has a temperature of 15 degrees Celsius. While the temperature of the condenser is 40 degrees Celsius. Of course, in the evaporator, mo-absorb siya og refrigerating load, Qrep, og mo-reject ang condenser og QR. Okay. So again, mabalik ta sa gitawag o generator. It is where the solution of lithium bromide and water is boiled. So, again, there is also what is called as an absorber. Aray mag-mix ang concentrated nga lithium bromide, which is residue from boiling. Okay. Then it will become saturated liquid and will be pumped up in the back in the generator. So in the generator, there is heat entered, which is the Qgen generator. This is the absorber. Okay, so we will again draw the points. This is point one. And the temperature of the generator is 90 degrees Celsius. And the temperature of the absorber is 35 degrees Celsius. So take note of that. 90 degrees Celsius, 35 degrees Celsius, 15 degrees Celsius, okay, and 40 degrees Celsius. So let's again write the points. It's 0.2, this is 0.3, 0.4, 5, 6, 7, okay, this is 0.8. Okay, the masses here, the flows here is the MR. Cycle diha ang MR. MR, okay? Here, what flows here is the MB. Here, what comes here is MA. So therefore, MA is equal to MR plus MB. MB, no? At absorber. So, muna siya mas balance na to. So, karon, okay, we are asked to find, so we are required to find COP of bar system, which is the lithium bromide system. So, that is our bar system. Okay, bar. So that is our system, which is equal to Q Q-rep over Q-gen plus work pump. So we have Q-rep of 1 ton of refrigeration. Okay. So we are also asked to find for COP maximum, which is the COP in Carnot principle of the equivalent of this vapor absorption refrigeration. Okay, namin tayo mga operating temperatures. Nga ring aside. This is our vapor power cycle. Okay, ana. So, COP max is also asked. And lastly is the Q absorber. Okay, so we're asked with the these three, no? So, the assumption assume work pump is negligible. Negligible. So, nil. Nil na siya. Negligible. Because, actually, work pump is very, very small in compared to the system. So, kung unless given, it is called negligible or nil. Approximately equal to zero. No? So that is nil. Kung dili given, pero given, i-add din yun, ha? For example, kini siya nga problem, assume work pump is negligible. So first, is we need to find the enthalpies at every point. So we need to find enthalpies at every point. So solution. So in order for you to understand, we will tabulate the points. Points, state, pressure, temperature, concentration. X is considered as concentration. So when we say X, it is the amount of lithium bromide per solution. Solution. Okay? So meaning kung 100% pure lithium bromide na siya. Okay, so kilogram per kilogram, which is the fraction of absorbent, which is ang atong absorbent diri is ang lithium bromide. Fraction of absorbent. Absorbent is lithium bromide per kilogram of solution. So that's what it means of the X. So meaning a fraction of lithium bromide at a point, no, pilay fraction na sa lithium bromide. So manay X. Then we have the enthalpy o ang mass nga nagdagan. So we have 8 points. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we have 8 points. So again, we will write the state, no? So the state of point 1 is saturated vapor. Saturated vapor, which is produced when boiling the water. Saturated vapor. So point 2 is saturated liquid. So ato na lang ibutang ang pressure para kausa na lang. So saturated liquid. So balik sa point 1, ang point 1 na asa umuni kay mumblitan mo static expansion valve o pump. So muni nagdivide sa high side o blue side. Kini. Blue na lang, blue. Ano? So, this is your high side. This is your low side. Remember that it is, this is the PSAT at T-con. This is also the PSAT at T-EBAP. So, when we look at the, I will share to you the kuan. So as you can see, lupon asir, andara. So as you can see here, so the at 40 degrees Celsius, the PSAT is approximately 7.38 kPa. For 15, it is 1.7 kPa. So we'll share again the whiteboard. Nihina yung itong internet kadyo sa ha o paniload. Okay, so we will go back to the points. Please bear with me. So, we will go back. So the pressure therefore, because this is the high side is the P sat at T con, where the low side the low side is the P sat at T bap, and we found out that the P sat of T con is 7.38 kPa. So this is because the condenser is located. Because point one is located in the high side, no, and the point two is saturated liquid and still located in the high side. Kaya wala pa man niagi og thermostatic expansion valve, which reduces the pressure. So, ang point three is a combination, no, of liquid and vapor. Pero ninaog na siya, niagi na ang point three sa thermostatic expansion valve. So, therefore, nana siya sa low side. So, ang iyang pressure there is 1.7 or 1.70 kPa. So, ang point 4 is saturated vapor pero naa siya sa low side. Naa siya sa low side. So, therefore, this is saturated vapor. Yan naa siya sa low side. Therefore, this is 1.70. So, this is for the rotation, kung tanaw na to ang masses diri, ang mass nga nagdagan diri sa 1, 2, 3, or 4 is the refrigerant. So, MR. So, MR. Diri. MR. MR. So, ang temperature sa atong point 1 is 90 degrees Celsius. Kay gikan man siya diri. Isit siya diri at 90. So, this is 90 degrees Celsius. Ang temperature sa atong point 2 is, of course, the T-sat, kay saturated man. Pares ni sila kay sa condenser. Okay? So, of course, kini siya kay kanang transformation, no? This is a combination of steam and vapor state. Liquid and vapor state. Sorry, liquid and vapor state. So, the evaporator has a temperature of how much? 15, 15. So, 15 degrees Celsius. So, this is for the MR. So, MR mo yung nagtuyok diha. So, meaning, walay lithium bromide diha. Remember that we boiled it here. So, when we boiled it here, the refrigerant, for example, you boil a seawater, ang evaporate ana, wala na kuyog asin. Pure water na siya. It is why, kung matrap ka sa Osaka Island, and when you boil the, when you boil seawater, like, for example, you made a fire na, you boil, then ang distillate anak, itong aso anak, pure water, siya mainom to kay inhabilin man ang salt or ang residue. So therefore, there is water na siya ang MR. Kay mo man atong refrigerant dere sa water lithium bromide, kini mo'y refrigerant, ang water lithium bromide mo'y absorbent. So, walay, wala siya'y, zero ni, or butangan natin zero. Zero, 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 and zero. Okay. So, ang enthalpy ani, so this is water, ato pangitaon sa steam table. Okay. So, arin nata sa 5, 6, 7, 8, which is, kung asa nagtuyok-tuyok ang lithium bromide. Naadari nagtuyok-tuyok ang lithium bromide, ana, LIBR. So, nadi ha. So, kung atong tanawon, ang state sa 0.5 is saturated liquid because this is a combination. State sa 0.5, kini, is a saturated liquid. So, ang temperatures, of course, the temperature of the absorber, which is 35, no? So, pero naa siya sa low side. So, kung tanawin niyo din, Ray, this is saturated liquid, low side, 1.7 kPa. Nya, 35 degrees Celsius. So, of course, kini ang niplow din, Ray, is ang MA. MA may niplow din, ha? No, awa. MA. MA. Dara, MA na siya ang niplow din, ha? Where MA is the sum of MR plus MB. So, asa pangitao ng concentration? Kaya na naman siya lithium bromide. Na siya lithium bromide. So, asa pangitao ng concentration? Ang concentration at to pangitaon sa PTX and HPTX chart. Okay, so how to find? How to find the concentration? First, we have pressure. Okay, so we have pressure, we have temperature. So ato ta sa PTX chart, nasa HTX chart. So para first pangitaon sa nato ang concentration. So ato ta sa chart. Okay? I-present ang chart. Okay. Presenting the chart. So this is the PTX. Wala pa, nag-loading. Okay. So what you are seeing now in your screen is the PTX chart, no? So remember that in 0.5 there is a pressure of 1.70. So I will doodle, no? 1.70. Kana. Read lang, read. Para akits mata. Na siya. So 1.70. So kaninga line. Kana. So we have a temperature of 35. Kini. Imit ni mo. Oh. Kani. Siya. Mit sa siya diri. Na meet. Okay. So, sa ako lang ba, sa tagaan lang tanig 50. Anyways, plus minus na dihadapit. So, somewhere din ha, no? So, kung 50 lang ako, kay para dalirang tultulon. Pero gusto mo na ay bungkig po. So, kini siya ang point. Meaning, this is your T, this is your P, this is your X. So, muna siya gitawag o T, X chart. Kay madakpan ninyo ang concentration dere sa PTX chart. So, therefore, the concentration dito sa 0.5 ninyo is 0.5. No? Okay. Okay, let's go back to the points. So, nakuha na to sa PTX chart. Okay, that the concentration here is 0.5. Drama mo rin ito, 0.48 or 0.5. Ako lang, 0.5. No? Anyways, that is dollar na. Okay. So, karon na nakay X. So karon, remember kining 1 2 3 4 1 ni problema. Kining enthalpy sa ning 1 2 3 4. Kini siya kana steam table na siya. ST steam table. So assuming kamo mamubasa ang steam table, no? Okay. So ang ato mang problema kay kining sa lithium bromide nga side naman ni mixture man eh, solution man eh. This is a combination of water and lithium bromide solution. So dili ni siya makit-an sa steam table, kaya ang steam table is only for pure water, pure substance nga water, walay mixture. Kini naay is a solution of lithium bromide and water. So lain sa ni siya ang value sa enthalpy kining dashed red nga rectangle. Anha din ha kanang kung asa gituyokan sa lithium bromide. So ang imuhang 1341 problema ato ka sa steam table. So karon pagitao nato ang enthalpy sa kuha naman natong concentration PTX chart kini nakuha na 0.5. So we find the enthalpy. Okay. So here we'll find the enthalpy. Please bear with me, no? Nanigid atong live. So, I will share screen again the kanina is the PTX karon kay ang HTX chart. So, window din ako naon ang chart. So, dara. I-share. Okay, so kini siya, wala pa na panigawas. Okay, dara. So kana siya muna ang PTX chart. Dirito nato gilugit ganina ang concentration. Karon na natay concentration. So arin sa ta sa HTX chart. So naatay temperature. So sa 0.5 atong temperature is 35. So tong dudulan approximately kini nga curve. Sundon sa ninyo mga curve kung wala din nagisuwat tunga-tunga ni 35 nya concentration 50 na. Aba. Di na nahiwi. So na naman ang 0.5 imo ra ning banggaon nang access sa 0.5. Na. Ni. So kung 50 ka, mong enthalpy ani is negative 160. So nganong nag negative 160 maka, so may problema na. Because according to chemistry, kung in exothermic, because remember this is a solution. So kung i-dissolve ko na nimo ang lithium bromide sa water, it will create an exothermic reaction. Nga kung exothermic reaction ko no, ingon ang mga chemist, it has a negative enthalpy. So mga chemist mo naswito gid ani nganong negative na siya. So naa sa mga negative 160. So our enthalpy for kana siya, sorry, tipas man. Na siya, no, sa 50 nga concentration na 35 nga temperature is between 40 and 30, no. So dinha niya 50 na pak diris kilid pang. Okay, ana. So, manaw na siya pag-read. So, I will stop sharing. I will go back again to the points. So the enthalpy here is approximately negative 160 kilojoules per kilogram. Okay. So muna siya. So ang state sa 6 is ang state sa 6 is liquid. Okay, na-pump naman siya sa water, no? So of course some way somehow na nay spontaneous cooling na liquefy na siya. So yeah, remember that at 0.6 nana siya above sa high, nana siya sa high side, therefore yung pressure is kini na nana sa high side, which is 7.38. so of course na spontaneous cooling, unknown ang yung temperature, pero di na siya kinahanglanon. So remember that the concentration in 5 is also the concentration in 6, kay muram na gida dito. So x 6 is equal to x5, which is 0.5. So actually the enthalpy of H6 is equals to H5 plus work pump, but again we consider work pump to be negligible, so therefore approximately H6 is equals to H5. So ang niplo dere is HM, ang mass dere is ang MA, so that is MA. So now here we sa 7.7 is the state of 0.7 is a saturated liquid state, no? So espeso nga liquid, no? Liquid na siya. So saturated liquid na siya, dapit. Saturated liquid. So naa siya sa high side, therefore 7.38 kPa. So ang iyang temperature is of course the temperature of the generator, which is 90 degrees Celsius. So we have PT, we need to find X. So the same method, we could find that the concentration using PTX, katong PTX ganina, si couple sige split share, no, sige balhin-balhin. So PTX, so nakay P, nakay T, makuha ni mong X, which is approximately 0.63. So, of course, na nakay T, nakay X, makuha ni mong enthalpy. So ang enthalpy niya is approximately negative 70 kilojoules per kilogram. So na ay negative enthalpy, chemical reaction kuno muna siya, exothermic reaction kuno, mixture of solution. Basta mga chemist pang tanana. So ang niplo dere is MB. MB na siya. MB. So ang 8 na to is again aging expansion valve. So ang atong point nilabang og expansion valve ang 0.8. Nilabang. So paglabang niya na himo og low side iyang pressure of 1.70. Again unknown iyang temperature, anyway dili man na siya angay hibaw kun. Okay, so remember that the concentration of X8 is equal to X7, which is 0.63. So 63% lithium bromide per solution. Okay, so again the since this is throttling, meaning again expansion valve, they have identical enthalpies, no? So kung kinisya ang H6 kay tungod na work pump na Nilman negligible, so kinisad siya, pareha sila kay na may expansion valve. So ani flow sa mastery MB. So karon ang atong problema kining H enthalpy aning 1 2 3 and 4. Okay, so remember that H1 is na siya dere, pabukala na siya, gika na siya dere. So ang enthalpy sa H1, ang enthalpy sa H1 is Hg at 90 degrees Celsius, kay saturated vapor man at 90 degrees Celsius. So talaw na nga to sa steam table. So H1 is approximately 2660.1 kilojoules per kilogram, no? At to kamutan na wana sa table 1 sa steam table. So H2 is exit sa condenser yan at to ni sa table 1 yapon 40 degrees Celsius. So HF at 40 degrees Celsius Tsat. So H2 is equal to HF, so that is 165.2 57 kilojoules per kilogram. So that we have now 1, 2. So again, H3 is equal to H2 because there is an expansion valve. So again, this is 165.57 kilojoules per kilogram. So H4 na lang. So remember that H4 is the exit of the evaporator, which is a saturated vapor state of Tsat negative, Tsat 15 degrees Celsius. So basically, vapor absorption, nga nung naani siya temperature above zero, kaya pwede na siya gamiton sa mga kanang, pwede na siya gamiton sa HVAC, no? Kay normally, ang temperature na nga kinahanglan, mga 4 degrees Celsius ra niya, ang water, chilled water system ba? Ang water ay ipadagan sa mga pan coil unit, which is dili necessary nga zero. Good. So, H4 is simply Hg at 15 degrees Celsius, Tsat sa table 1. So H4, so I assume nga kamao mumuba sa steam table kay og di wa na gyud taani gyud. So this is ang H4 is equal to Hg at 15, which is 2528.9 kilojoules per kilogram. So we have completed the enthalpies at every point 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, 8. So approximately work pump is assumed negligible. So therefore, H6 is approximately equal to H5. Okay. So now what do we do? So again, in problem A, we are asked to find COP of the bar, which is equal to Q rep over Q gen plus work pump. Q gen, meaning the heat that is applied or inputted into the generator plus work pump, which is of course negligible na siya, pero given na siya diri. So we need to solve for Qgen. So how do we solve for Qgen? So we can solve Qgen. We can solve Qgen using mass balance at using energy balance at generator. So for energy balance at generator. Energy balance at generator. Okay, if this is your generator, I'm drawing a generator, man siya. So ang exit sa inyong generator is DMR. This is at point 1. Ang nisod sa generator is point 6, which is from the pump, which is MA, no? Nya ang ni-exit diri. Okay, para di mo maglibog, ato na lang inatuon pag layout. Tara. Na. Na, muna niyo ang gusto. Besra na siya. Na. So, ngari, ang nisod diri, this is 0.6 again. MA. Na, para dali rasab ton. Na, 7. This is MB. Again, remember that there is heat inputted in the form of Qgen, meaning kisod ang Qgen. So, summation of energy in is equal to summation of energy out. So, ang niina to is ang Qgen, of course, plus MA H6 is equals to MR H1 ang ni-out plus MB H7. So, ang problema, natay mga masis by wala tayo na question mark na mga masis ka na. Na, wala na tayo na. So, before we could solve for Qgen, which will be used for COP, for the masis. So, you lose your connection. Hey. will present again kay nawa ang connection. Please bear with me. Kailangan ko na nangyayin siya. Okay, we'll share again the whiteboard. Okay, so as you can see, pinakadali nga math nga itong ma-solve the ICQ because it's given to be one time projection, which is equals to MR times H4 minus H3. Because this is the exit of the evaporator, this is the entrance of the evaporator. So wala pa siya na present. So rip. Okay. Okay, balik na ta. So, ang pinakadaling ma-solve is si MR. So, again, 3.516 kilojoules per second, which is kilowatt, is MR times H4, 2528.9 minus 165.57 kilojoules per kilogram. Cancel ang kilojoules, so the MR will be in. So, therefore, MR, using this shape solve, so, is equal to 0.00149 kilogram per second. So, that is the mass flow of the water or the refrigerant. So, now, refrigerant, okay na. Problema. A man or B, mass A or mass B. So, we could solve mass A and mass B through lithium bromide balance at absorber. So, LIBR balance at absorber. So, when we say absorber, okay, we draw the absorber para siyaro, no? So, ito yung entrance ni Sodre. So, ni Sodre si 0.4. So, there is si 0.4. Nagda sa MR, no? So, naay ni gawas dire si 0.5. Nagda sa MA. Yan ay ni so dire si MB at 0.8. Okay? So, mo ba? 4, 8, and 5. So, therefore, we could say that summation of LIBR mass in, masses ha, really energy in, is equals to summation of LIBR mass out. So, ang mass in is, again, concentration. So, kung natay MR dere, X4. So, concentration. So, ama, fraction, pilay fraction aning MR, so fraction man siyang X4. So, plus MB X8. Okay? So, is equal to, so in man, ang out, si MA X5. Okay? So, remember that X4 is 0 because this is water. So, automatically, everything of this will be 0. So, what is left is that MB X8 is equal to MA X5, no? So remember, as you can recall, MA is equals to MR plus MB, no? So we have MR, can I solve them not previously sa Q-rip. Therefore, we substitute MB x8 is equals to MR plus MB times x5. Okay. So, therefore, we substitute MB. So, x8 is 0.63, which is equal to the concentration at 0.7. It's equal to MR, which is 0.00149 kilogram per second plus MB. Okay, so we only have one variable, which is MB, times 0.5 approximately. So, concentration sa x5. So, therefore, ship solved, MB is approximately 0.00573 kilogram per second. Okay, so we have MB and MR. So, remember that MA is equal to the sum of MR and MB. So, MA is equal to 0.00149 plus 0.00573. It equals to 0.00722 kilogram per second. So, muna siya, nakuha na nato ang mga masses, including the refrigerant. So, let us go back to solving for the Hugin. So, using, again, the energy balance, we manipulate Hugin equals to MR, H1, plus MB, H7, minus MA, H6. So, gika ni siya din rin. Gitranspose rin siya. Gitranspose. Na. So, we substitute the values to solve for the Hugin so that we could have now our COP. 0.00149 times H1, which is 2660.1 plus, okay, plus MB, which is 0.00573 times negative 70, which is our H7, minus MA, MA 0.00722 times negative 160 kilojoules per kilogram. So, Hugin, we use calculator. So, 0.00149 times 2660.1 plus 0.00573 times negative 70 plus minus 0.00722 times negative 160. Okay. So we check 0.00149 times 2660.1 plus 0.00573 times negative 70 plus minus 0.00722 times negative 160. So that will be 4.72 kilowatts. So, remember that the COP of this bar is sometimes less than 1. Gamay jud kay ni siya og COP. So, therefore, the COP is equal to 3.516 over 4.72 kilowatts. Okay, because this is kilogram per second, so cancel kilogram, kilojoules per second, kilowatts. So that will be 3.516 divided by 2.48 divided by 4.72. 3.516 divided by 4.72, 0.745. Gamay gina og COP, less than 1 ang COP sa vapor absorption refrigeration. So, kay pilang day ang highest day ay. Tanawa ang highest, ha? So, remember, letter B, we have COP max of TL over TH minus TL for the rep times TH minus TL over TH. So, when we substitute the values, this is 15 plus 273 over 40 minus 15 times we have TH of 90 minus 35 over 90 plus 273. So, the highest possible COP using Carnot is only 1.745. So, meaning everything, meaning COP, this is COP max. So, meaning that this is more than, this should be more than COP bar. Dilita pwede mulapas, ana. Dita pwede mulapas, ani. No? So, dapat less than, yun eh, which is less than COP max. So, muna siya. 0.00149 times 266. Okay. So, we solve for the Q absorber. So, the Q absorber. Again, solution in order to solve for Q absorber is that we need to have the energy balance at absorber. Okay? So, if this is your absorber, and so many souls yung mga absorber, nga energies ha, dili masses. This is MR4. So, dire 8. So, MB. Okay? Dire, ano gawas? Ana, si M5. Oh, MA, sorry. At 0.5. So, remember, this is energy. So, if this is your absorber, na energy nga nigawas dire nga gitawag og si Q-abs. So, summation of energy in is equals to summation of energy out. Therefore, we have that MR in man. So, MR H4 plus MB H8 in out equals MA H5 plus Q absorber. Therefore, we substitute the value 0.00149 times 28.9 plus MB. 0.00573 times negative 70 is equals to 0.00722 times negative 160. Okay, plus Q abs, let's ship solve. So Q abs is ship solve. So that is 0.00149 times 2 pi 2 8.9 plus 0.00573 times negative 70. 0.00573 times negative 70 alpha equals 0.00722 times negative 160 plus alpha x. If solve, that is Q of is approximately 4.5 kilowatts. Okay, so that is all about lithium bromide, water lithium bromide vapor absorption refrigeration. Thank you very much. So I will send the activity in regards to this vapor absorption refrigeration system in the Google Classroom.